وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى. In this episode, I want to speak about the ayah that I promised that I will talk about. In Surah Al-Hashr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says,
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in this verse, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe, اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ, be fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ, let every single person look at what they have put forth for tomorrow. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ, be fearful of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ, verily Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is one who has deep knowledge of what you all do. This verse, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he starts by quoting us, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, those of you who believe. And this ayah is very powerful because it's a foundation for the topic that we're going to be speaking about, which is hasibu anfusakum qabla an tuhasabu. To look at your actions and contemplate and ponder over it before you meet Allah yawm al-qiyamah, before you meet Allah ghadan, tomorrow. This ayah, Al-Allama Abdul Rahman Nasir Sa'di, the great scholar, the great mufassir, the teacher of Al-Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih Al-Uthaymeen, he says, هذه الآية الكريمة أصل في محاسبة العبد نفسه وأنه ينبغي له أن يتفقدها فإن رأى زللا تداركه بالإقلاع عنه والتوبة النصوح والإعراض عن الأسباب الموصلة إليه وإن رأى نفسه مقصرا في أمر من أوامر الله بذل جهده واستعان بربه في تكميله وتتميمه وإتقانه ويقايس بين منن الله عليه وإحسانه وبين تقصيره فإن ذلك يوجب له الحياء بلا محالة. The great scholar, he says, this ayah is a foundation. It's a fundamental verse. It's a powerful verse. It's a principle, this verse, for this concept of muhasabatul abdi nafsahu. To look at your actions. Look at your speech. Account yourself. This ayah is an aslun. It's a foundation in this matter. وَأَنَّهُ يَنْبَغِي لَهُ أَن يَتَفَقَدَ. And this is something that we should try to look deeply into ourselves and try to find. فَإِنْ رَأَى زَلَلًا, if you see a shortcoming, a fault in yourself, تَدَارَكَهُ بِالْإِقْلَاعِ عَنْهُ, the person rushes to rectify it. وَالتَّوْبَةِ النَّصُوحِ, and the person comes with sincere repentance. وَالْإِعْرَاضِ, and the person also turns away from, عَنِ الْأَسْبَابِ الْمُوصِلَةِ إِلَيْهِ, any means that will lead you to that shortcoming. وَإِنْ رَأَى نَفْسَهُ مُقَصِّرًا, and if the person sees that they are falling short, في أمر من أوامر الله, in a command from the commandments of Allah, بدل جهده, the person exerts all of his efforts, واستعان بربه, and he seeks help from his Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in what? في تكميله وتتميمه, in completing your nafs, okay, وإتقاني, and to perfect yourself, ويقايس بين منن الله عليه, and of course comparing between the blessing of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala وإحسانه وبين تقصيره, comparing the blessing of Allah and how he's bestowing his mercy and his favors onto you, and here you are coming with shortcomings. فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ يُوجِبُ لَهُ الْحَيَاءَ, because that will then necessitate, once you see that Allah is favoring you, blessing you, and here you are not being upright, what will that necessitate? It will necessitate shyness. بِلَا مَحَالَ, without a doubt. So this ayah is a very powerful ayah, as the Imam rahimahullah mentioned. And it's an ayah which a person should really try to, what it's commanding you, you try to look for it in yourself. This ayah is أَعْظَمُ حَثٍ عَلَى مُحَاسَبَةِ النَّفْسِ. Just remember that it's the strongest verse that encourages مُحَاسَبَةُ النَّفْسِ. Okay? And what the ayah mentions is, a part of the verse is وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ. Look at what you have done for tomorrow. And this shows how powerful the verse is. Look at yourself in what you have prepared for tomorrow. The ayah referred to it as tomorrow. What have you put forward for it? And the word غد is tomorrow. It's not something far. Allah mentioned it in the Quran in many places that the day of judgment and death is very close. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. They see it to be far, we see it to be close. Allah says in another ayah, أَزِفَتِ الْأَزِفَةِ. Allah also says in another ayah, إِقْتَرَبَتِ السَّاعَةِ وَانْشَقَّ الْقَمَرِ. In another place Allah said, إِقْتَرَبَ لِلنَّاسِ حِسَابُهُمْ وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مُعْرِضُونَ. All of those verses elaborate and convey the message of the day of judgment and death is something very close to every single one of us. So even if it is tomorrow that you're going to die literally, or if it's 2 days, or 3 days, or 4 days, or even a week, or even if it's a month, or even if it's a year or two or three, all of that is nothing long. The Prophet told us, عليه الصلاة والسلام, أعمار أمتي ما بين 60 و 70 وقليل من يجوز ذلك. The lifespan of the children of Adam is between 60 to 70, and little go overboard. You're not going to live here forever and ever and ever. And no one actually knows when he's going to die. So because you don't know, it's something which is majhool, unknown to you. You should always be prepared and always be ready. Allah tells us in the Quran, He says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثِ وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ, to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is what? The knowledge of the unseen. عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ, the knowledge of the hour is only known to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثِ, Allah sends out the rain subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ, Allah knows what is in the wombs. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا, no one actually knows what they're going to achieve tomorrow. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ, a person doesn't know where they're going to die tomorrow. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ, Allah has this quality, this characteristics, this attribute of knowledge, ilm. Human's knowledge is restricted. Allah has infinite knowledge and is khabir subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ayah says, وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ. Let every single person look at what they put forth for tomorrow, the day they're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also the ayah mentions, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ twice. This quality of taqwa. Because تَمَامِ مُحَاسَبَةِ النَّفْسِ, from the, يعني, to complete this quality of thinking and pondering and contemplating and critically analyzing your actions and your speech, it comes by way of taqwa. That's why the ayah repeated it twice. Ya alladhina amanu taqu Allah. And then again he said, wattaqu Allah. Because taqwa is min tamami muhasabati nafsi. And that is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said, قال أخذ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بمنكبي. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم grabbed my shoulders. فقال, he said to me, كن في الدنيا كأنك غريب أو عابر سبيل. Be in this world like a stranger or a person who's crossing a road. ولذلك عبد الله بن عمر, from that day onwards he used to say, إذا أمسيت فلا تنتظر الصباح. If the morning, if you see the evening, don't wait for the morning. وإذا أصبحت فلا تنتظر المساء. And if you come, if you see the morning, then don't wait for the evening. وَخُذْ مِنْ صِحَتِكَ لِمَرَضِكَ وَمِنْ حَيَاتِكَ لِمَوْتِكَ. Benefit from whilst you have health before illness strikes you, and benefit from this life before death comes to you. That is muhasabatul nafs. Look at Abdullah ibn Umar, look what he did. The Prophet said to him, "Kun fi dunya ka'annaka gharibun aw aabiru sabil." Straight away, what did he say? فَإِذَا أَمْسَيْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الصَّبَاحَ وَإِذَا أَصْبَحْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الْمَسَاءَ وَخُذْ مِنْ صِحَّتِكَ لِمَرَضِكَ وَمِنْ حَيَاتِكَ لِمَوْتِكَ. Straight away he contemplated and he pondered over the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that's how he lived. ولذلك, this ayah that we are reading, Al-Allamah Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti rahimahullah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. Al-Allamah Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti commented on it, and he said, في هذه الآية الكريمة حث على تقوى الله في الجملة. Allah urged us in this great verse, he says, to come with taqwa of Allah تبارك وتعالى. واقترنت بالحث على النظر والتأمل. And with it mentioned is what? Right next to it is to ponder and contemplate. فيما قدمت كل نفس لغد. What every single person has prepared for tomorrow. وتكرر الأمر فيها بتقوى الله. Look what he says. The term تقوى has come twice. Why? مما يدل على شدة الاهتمام والعناية بتقوى الله. Because of the importance of تقوى and how much it is in regards to this matter we're talking about. And Allah تبارك وتعالى, he told us that the best provision a person can take is تقوى. As Allah تبارك وتعالى said in the ayah, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيَرَ الزَّادِ تَقْوَى وَاتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Take your provision with you. For verily the best to take is what? فَإِنَّ خَيَرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. Taqwa is the best. وَاتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. وَلِذَلِكَ ابْنُ رَجَبْ, when it came to the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar, which I mentioned, كُنْ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَأَنَّكَ غَرِيبٌ أَوْ عَابِرُ سَبِيلٌ. Ibn Rajab, in his sharh of kitab Jam Ulum al-Hikam, he says, وهذا الحديث أصل في قصر الأمر في الدنيا وأن المؤمن لا ينبغي له أن يتخذ الدنيا وطنا ومسكنا فيطمئن فيها ولكن ينبغي أن يكون فيها كأنه على جناح سفر يهيئ جهازه للرحيل. علامة ابن رجب الحنبلي, the great scholar, the student of Ibn Kathir and Ibn al-Qayyim, or the student of Ibn al-Qayyim, and he says, this hadith, he says, is a foundation في قصر الأمر في الدنيا, that you should see this dunya to be very short. وأن المؤمن لا ينبغي له أن يتخذ الدنيا وطنا ومسكنا, that the believer should not take this world as a place of permanent residency. فيطمئن فيها, where he relaxes and he gives himself to it. ولكن ينبغي أن يكون فيها كأنه على جناح سفر. He should see this world as though he's a traveler. يهيئ جهازه للرحيل. He's preparing his instruments and his tools to leave this place. Here, you don't open your bags. You know when you're a traveler, you're transit in a country for a day or two. You stay in the hotel. You don't take out all of your products and leave it there. You only take out what is important for you to use at that moment and you leave the rest inside your bag. That's how the person should be in this dunya. I'm going to stop there inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I've said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi ashadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.